to have the trade being denominated and settled in the Chinese yuan. Of course, that Russian bank mechanism will allow the yuan to really to be floating to different parts of the world. So therefore, that the degree to which that they should really internationalize the renminbi, and again, this is really a subject that the China government has always been really scared about that opening up the market too soon because of pressure on the exchange rate side, because that they really worry that by losing out, it is really causing the instability to the economy, and so therefore, that right now, that they are really looking a bit. Open up the market and index the currency control very, very good. Of course, another part, which is the growing reserve in China, and that was the figures of 2008. Of course, now I mean that the foreign currency reserve in China has already surpassed $2 trillion. So, of course, that's a lot of money that has been invested.
While for B shares, it is really available to both the domestic and
1001 B-share is also accessible to the local investor provided that they really have the required foreign currencies. Besides the list of shares traded in Shanghai and Shenzhen, that we have also the B-shares which are really traded in Hong Kong, which anyone can buy because Hong Kong does not really have any capital control. So in fact, the B-share market has really been prospering in the last few years because really have diminished and become smaller. course, the premium does not really disappear. Because the index I showed you that it is really a market capitalization weighted index. So it is more weighted to the larger companies and smaller weighted to the smaller companies. And so that's why that I did ask my assistants to look at their individual companies as a year ago and then come up with their average price ratio. So what we find is that for the AB share, the average price ratio is about 2 times. So therefore, the premium is about 100%. Now, the A shares, the average price ratio is 1.63, so that is a net premium of 63%. If you look at the median, so instead of really looking at the average, the simple average of the median, then in that case, the premium gets smaller. What we also compare is really the average trading volume ratio, and that for the B shares, you can see that the trading volume is much, much lower relative to the A share market. And so therefore, this is showing you that in fact the B share market has a is very different and does not really trade much, and therefore this is a market that is certain to be really to be closed up very soon. But it's just a question of the when that it will be. On the other hand, the share market has really been very vibrant. Share market as freely as they would like. So why are there different types of shares? Basically, that is certainly is the capital control, because that otherwise that you always allow Mr. Hartman to come in and out. And so that's why the type of share in order to restrict the participation of the foreign investors. And second is also that a lot of times the government is always worried about these foreign investors, thinking about that they always destabilize the stock market, and so that's why that they also try to really set in the market limit that the playing field for the investors so they size that they think that they can really manage. And so therefore that the as the China market is trying to open up, I mean that this one means that they really need to really act. So here, just to show you that some of the major events in the Chinese stock market development, and so what I just want to say is that really in the first half of, I mean this is again, it's a very short history, I mean but that the market has really grown long. Negotiation process, but at the end it really worked out, and for most of I also want to highlight in the second half of the business stock market development, there are really trying to allow a lot more participation by different types of investors. Then there's a QFII program, QDII program. And so, I mean, for the QFII program, so these are really qualified for institutional investors. So allowing these investors to buy the agent with a certain lockup period. The amount is not being paid. I mean, in fact, that this amount of 30 billion subject to allocation so far is only 17 billion have been allocated. I mean, that is really, really tiny relative to the overall stock market capitalization. And so this is something that needs to really to work better. The other one is this qualified domestic institutional investors. So it's really the other side, allowing the domestic investors, primarily bank, mutual funds, insurance company, to invest into the market outside the Asian. So again, the amount is not really that big. And in fact, that there are a lot more poker being not used simply because they are really not that much demand. It's very interesting because if you think that these domestic investors would really like to build a more diversified portfolio by investing into the international market, but that is not the case. Even with QDII, not many of these there are not really that much that many investors subscribing to that simply because of an issue regarding the expectation of the exchange rate. Because they realize that 2006 is really going up to 20,000 allow the demand to be more flexible, and therefore in fact that we see that in the last few years the rent has been appreciated by almost 20%. So therefore that the domestic investors realize that this might not really be that good in order to really invest in foreign securities, because that once it is really in back into the domestic currency, that they might really that the capital profile, so I think the exchange rate loss might even be higher than the capital gains from their foreign securities. So this is a very interesting one because it's really part of this liberalization. And that's also highlighting one of the risks investing into the China market with policy risk. And what happens is that in 2007 August, there are really opinion from the China government saying that they are going to have this food chain initiative, which is to allow the investors in China to buy these Hong Kong business shares through a particular branch in Bank of China in Tianjin. So now is the question. So one is that why is Bank of China? And second is that why is Tianjin? And so therefore that no one exactly knows, but of course that a lot of times that what these policies that are come up with, that a lot of that is where maybe have a lot of political reasons. So in fact that this one that it could be that simply is because that the Tianjin from Tianjin, if you have come from China, you know the Tianjin is about 100 miles away from Beijing, and that is very close to Beijing, and so that is also a considered topic for some of these Brazilian government officials. And so somehow that they are really the one that are trying to push that. Has been So in fact that if you look at what the China government is doing, and that is also sometimes the support of Hong Kong, what they are really trying to do is to circumvent this capital control, but try to really to allow a much more uniform price for this different types of shares trading in China and Hong Kong. Now this is really focused.
Investors are not just responding all the way to this price differential, so are there any factors that really
So in fact, if you really want to ask the question, so we need to really get a bit more data on that,
bottom line in that whole
that they should really be entitled to the same. They allow the domestic methods are
allowed.
Yes. Well, the reason here is at least in the last nine years. So that's why that we look at this behavior after 2001, after that these domestic investors are allowed to buy these shares, and also that we find that they do have foreign currencies, so they have no problem buying the shares. So,
when you consider modeling, you take this into consideration?
It's true that the question that you have is good one. I mean, the mortality is much higher than the mortality of the species, even higher than the mortality of the species. So now the question is that, what's the implication of this assistance in the mortality? But if you really think about some kind of an asset pricing theory, I mean that you really have a higher risk in terms of asset volatility, you should really have a high expected return. So we should really translate into a higher A share price relative to B share or A share. But it is really the opposite. So therefore, that this volatility difference does not seem to really have any implication for price difference.
I have a question and a microphone, so. So I'm quite curious if you have any, went by and asked, did you look at the duration in which people who bought these shares held them and then resold them for capital gains, and the same for A shares? Because knowing sort of stereotypes, it's probably the same in the other markets. Oftentimes people aren't really investing based upon fundamental values, but based upon capital gains. And so if it's the case that if the holding duration results in the same expected capital gains, then wouldn't it be sort of a justified, then wouldn't the premium that we're observing, the discount that we're observing, be justified?
Have a lot of domestic investment.
the different requirements concerning corporate governance if shares are listed in Hong Kong or mainland China, and do these standards are the same as in the United States, so they meet the requirements of Sarbanes-Oxley Act or not yet?
Well, surely